High Law is brought to you by Corvus Vodka, the official vodka of Pro Football Hall of Famer Ty Law, by 110 Grill, modern American cuisine and a top allergy-friendly restaurant, by FindMassMoney.gov, and by Drains by James, Eastern Mass's choice for drain cleaning and pipelining. They give a poop about your pipes, and Ty Law joins us on the Harbor One hotline. Hey, Ty.
Hey, what's going on, guys? How you doing? Good morning.
Who do you want to see a week from Sunday, Pats versus Jets, when it comes to the quarterback?
Whoever go.
I mean,
out there
what
and
I
play
say,
hard.
Jets. Sorry, Giants. Pats versus Giants. Who do you want to see?
I mean, at this point, does it even make a difference? I'll answer it for you. No, it don't even make a difference if it's Bailey Zappi, Will Levis, whatever his name is,
Greer.
And Matt Jones. Greer, I don't care. It don't make a damn difference. That means, Greg, you can go out there and play quarterback. We don't care.
Well, but you've been on teams that have been struggling, and what about when Devin McCourty says maybe those guys get a little bump from it, from a change of quarterback?
I mean, it's going to create some competition, I guess, in practice, but you should have figured this out a long time ago. I mean, you think about it. At this point, do you go out there and say, what kind of statement are you making other than we gave up on our quarterback? What other kind of statement is you making? Because now, okay, if you're already making that decision and you're going to get rid of Mac Jones and he's not the quarterback of the future, wouldn't it make somewhat a little bit of sense if he went out there and played and tried to get some value out of him if you're going to trade him?
No.
You don't want to give nothing up, or you get first round draft pick.
I mean,
try to get something out of them.
I
just don't know if what's that going to do to the team, to the locker room. I mean, I'm not there to know how people are feeling right now within the organization. Does the players, are they tired of Mac Jones antics? I don't know. I mean, he might have a lot of friends on there. I mean, all of them are struggling. Ain't nobody playing great, but the quarterback is always getting the brunt of the wins and losses. You know what I mean? They got to take it both ways. So I just think at this point, get something out of him, if you can. But Bailey, he came in there. Maybe he might start a spark. You still ain't going to the damn playoffs.
I'd ask you this, ask Wiggy, Shime, Curtis, whatever. Mac Jones, if you're going away from Mac Jones at the end of the season, does his value change if he continues to play? I mean, if he plays better than he has remainder of this season, do you get more from him, or is the league pretty much set on what he is in your mind?
I think you will get more from him if he has a good run down the stretch, because I still think a lot of people like myself, not saying he's a great quarterback like at all, but I said if you give him some weapons and maybe a different system, a better foundation, he will be a better quarterback, a more serviceable quarterback. But right now, for whatever reason, they're not getting through to him. You know what I mean? He showed some signs as a young player, as a rookie. So he has some upside. So if he can turn it around and just play some decent ball, somebody might give you a draft pick for him. And take him off your hands, and you at least get compensated for all the trouble and hard time that we've been feeling around here.
But only problem is that if he's bad, then you get even less. But Ty, let me ask you this question, because you've played the position at a high level. You're a Hall of Famer. You know how difficult it is to play against an elite, elite wide receiver. If you're the GM of the New England Patriots at the end of the season, are you taking a quarterback or are you taking Marvin Harrison Jr.?
It depends on which quarterback is available, but when you have a talent like Marvin Harrison Jr., I'm trying to tell you, he can cause havoc. You know, if you get him out there, if he's everything we expect him to be with his pedigree and what he's done in college football, and he can make an average quarterback look better. So if he is available and you don't have a quarterback that you see as the face or the future, you damn right you take that talent, because he's going to make somebody better than what they really are. That's the type of talent that he has.
Ty, what would you rather?
But I will say, if you have a quarterback, if you do have a quarterback that say, hey, this dude can play and he can be the future, if it's even close, take the quarterback.
Ty, what would you rather? Bill next season, run it back with everything that they've got right now, Bill next season without Mac Jones, or Mac Jones stays and you get rid of the head coach, or you blow up the entire thing?
I say if Bill leaves, you blow up the entire thing. In my opinion, Bill leaves, blow up the entire thing. But I would rather see Bill step back, and because I know he can still coach, step back from the GM, get some players in there. Mr. Kraft, open up that checkbook, you know, back up the Brinks truck for a couple guys. And I think that they can still be a competitive football team, because I really think that Coach Belichick is a great coach. But he has to have players. He has to realize that you don't have the same quarterback that you used to have. You don't have the same players, the same dogs that you used to have in that locker room that you didn't have to police. You have to police too much right now, and you need some new players. So in order to be able to police that, what you're going to need to do, you need to step back and get into the locker room and get out of the front office, in my opinion. But I still think he's a great coach. But I'm hearing all these things with Orlovsky and saying he's going somewhere else. It's already predetermined. And I will piggyback on this. Guys, I told you, if it is something like that out there, if it's just a rumor, but if there's any truth to it, I told you he's going to be pulling the cards. He's going to be playing the strings. I mean, this is all on him. If it's anything predetermined, Bill Belichick is holding all the damn cards.
Not the Krafts.
Not when it comes to where he's going. If it's already predetermined, you're not going to tell Bill Belichick. Hold on, Greg. Did he just not sign a contract extension that ain't nobody know about?
Yeah, they have him under contract, so they can theoretically direct, I guess, where he ends up and who if it's going to be a trade, who they end up doing it with.
Greg, it's your show. You can theoretically tell me to go over here, but I don't mean I got to go. You can theoretically tell me to take my ass over to the other station, but I don't got to go.
That's true.
I'm going to go where I want to go. No, hell no. So guess what? Coach Belichick, you're not going to tell me that I'm going to go to some other team after all I've done and I signed a new contract. No, guess what? I got a guaranteed coach's contract, and if I don't want to go somewhere, damn it, I ain't going. I'll retire before I let you do that.
Ty, is there any chance, though, that you think Bill Belichick will acquiesce and say, okay, I'll give up the power of the roster and allow somebody else to pick the players and remain in Foxborough?
You know what? I'm saying he could if he wants to stay there, but he might want to change himself. I've even heard San Diego, who ain't going to – hey, guess what? At least they got a quarterback. It ain't like he's playing lights out, but damn, they got some talent over there. And I'm going to California.
Yeah, local,
man,
the owners
ain't nothing wrong with that. That ain't a bad trade-off, but best believe he is going to dictate where he's going to go. That's like when you have those guaranteed contracts, like the NBA. They can force themselves to go where they want to go, or they shut it down.
Right. And
Bill Belichick will shut it down.
And Ty, I mean, you know this better than anybody. He has the leverage, because no matter how bad they are this year, he's going to have an opportunity to do what he wants elsewhere. So that's why I don't see him, unless it's just important for him to stay and he likes the area, that could be the case. But all things being equal, I don't see him giving up power when he has the opportunity to maintain that power and do this elsewhere.
Exactly. And he has the power to demand or whatever he wants if he goes somewhere else. You don't think if, let's say, hypothetically, Bill Belichick was a free agent, come one, come all, you don't think, you know, it'd be damn near 10, 15 teams that's coming and want to at least check out the opportunity and see if we can get Bill Belichick? Come on, man. Like I said, and it's guaranteed. Josh McDaniels, guess what? He got fired, right? He getting all his damn money. He getting it all. If Bill Belichick just signed an extension, he getting all his money.
See, I don't think.
I mean, so it makes no sense when people say Mr. Kraft is going to do this, do that. No, he don't control those calls. You control what happens in the Patriots organization. But when it comes to Bill Belichick, there's an exception to every rule. And you're not just going to go off and trade Bill Belichick to somewhere that he does not want to go or he does not approve.
Right. And that's why I agree with you. Bill does hold the cards tight. And the other thing, I don't think Robert wants to potentially open up the door for Bill to go elsewhere when he could end up in your division, let's say with the Buffalo Bills, and now you not only let Brady go, who got away, but now What if Bill ended up with the Bills? Because you're going to have a laundry list of teams wanting Belichick, especially teams that know, hey, we only need this guy for a couple of years to get us to a Super Bowl and win one. You think Robert wants to know, like, he has to face Bill twice a year in the division? Whether it's the Bills or, and I even brought up, no, I didn't bring it up, but Christian, I can't say the Jets, they want to win a Super Bowl and they're willing to do whatever.
Facts. And like I said, it's definitely now, that's where Mr. Kraft will sit there have something to say if it's going to be within the division. Now, he's not going to, like, he has some type of leverage because of the contract, whatever the language is. I don't think, unless he's an absolute free agent and you get fired. But I don't think Mr. Kraft is smart enough that I got him under contract. I ain't just about to fire him. I'm going to get something out of him. Now, where is we going to work this out? Where is he going to go? I'm not about to trade you to in within the division. I'm not going to do that unless I get a hell of a lot back. So I don't think Mr. Kraft, he's too smart of a businessman to do that. But I do think that if he was a free agent, I'm not saying the Jets because I think they like their head coach, but Buffalo with their quarterback and some of the pieces that they have, Bill Belichick might be able to go up there and turn that around. He's going to look at that quarterback and say, I can work with that. You know, I can see him San Diego. I can see him going up there, and he's 70-something years old. He going to the sunshine. He still love coaching. Hell, I got me a quarterback there, and I got some pieces. I got a receiver. He has some pieces up there. But to say going to Buffalo or New York within the division, I don't think that that's going to happen. I mean, Mr. Kraft's not going to let that happen.
No, that's why.
Even though it would be a hell of a storyline.
When everybody talks Commanders, that's a rebuild.
Right, he ain't going there.
He's not going to go there and do that.
No, he ain't going now. He's not going to go to Commanders. I mean, no, that's not going to happen. But I do think if it's a good opportunity where they have some type of foundation, a solid quarterback, and they got some pieces, I wouldn't, out to question that. Bill Belichick and say, you know what, I'll go here, but it's going to be on my terms.
Do you think Bill would ever go somewhere where he's just the GM? Director of football operations?
No. I think he loves coaching too much.
He needs to pass Shula. You don't do that as a GM.
Yeah.
I think he'd go somewhere.
I can't see that.
I think he'd go somewhere, Ty, and take less of a GM role to coach, and as long as he's working
with... Well, why wouldn't he just do that here then?
I think he would.
If he's willing to do that, you think he would?
I think he would, as long as Robert was willing to say, all right, Bill, I'll open up the checkbook with you and whoever is going to communicate about the players we potentially bring in.
Wait, so according to your logic, Wiggy, Bill Belichick has wanted to spend but been unable to because of Robert Kraft.
Yes.
Now he's going to give up the ability to decide where that money is finally spent on, but Robert Kraft's going to spend it.
No, not Robert's going to spend it. Bill's going to work with the new GM who has maybe a little bit more say, but Robert's saying, I'm willing to spend the money.
So Bill Belichick's entering a lame duck season, giving up power and allowing somebody he's never worked with.
I didn't say give up complete power. No, and it has to be somebody he knows.
What about Nick Caserio? Like, do you think he'd be open to Nick Caserio coming back here in a true GM role?
Yep, I think it would be anybody that he's worked with to come back in the GM role, and they'll know, like, Bill's still going to have his input, and then he'll ultimately...
But Casario's running his own shop, and he's got next quarterback, and he's got great organization.
Who's the guy, Dave Ziegler, who just got fired?
Yeah.
Maybe it's somebody like that.
Yeah.
I mean, there's a lot of guys. Maybe it's Matt Groh.
Huh. No, I mean, you know what, Wiggy guys, Curtis, you talk about somebody coming in, no matter who it is, they're always going to feel like they're walking on eggshells because it's Bill Belichick and the New England Patriots. So anybody coming there, even though they have the title, unless it's somebody like you guys were talking about that's been there, he has a relationship with, it's going to be – I think that can be a recipe for disaster because this has been the Bill Belichick show for so long. And then whoever comes in, it's no, that ain't going to work. It's going to have to be – somewhere else because he has always had the power. We talk about stepping back. We'd like to see it, but who's going to come in there and say, and if Bill Bell say, I don't want this person, and they're going to take him anywhere.
Well,
see, that's the difference. Who is going to sit there and make that point and say, you know what, Bill, I'm going to do this anyway. You just coach. Ain't nobody about to do that to Bill.
It is certainly going to be interesting, and we will keep talking about it with you. I am glad you took the time this morning. I think you wanted to, before you go, you wanted to mention something going on over the weekend?
Yeah. You know what? It's an unfortunate situation happened, so we're going to postpone the event that we were doing. Okay. You know, so, family matter.
Oh, hold on.
So we're not going to happen this week.
Is this one segment in which you will not be plugging something that you're doing?
Nope. I ain't plugging nothing. But
all right,
man, I'm coming back home.
Okay.
I'm just here. We're just here talking football, talking Patriots, and talking to you guys right now. Because I'm out here walking in L.A. I'm still in L.A. right now. I'm out here walking in the streets. You know, it's light out. I ain't got to worry about looking over my back. So it's a good day. Starting off a good day.
All right. Well, we will talk to you again next week on Tuesday. All right, Ty?
All right. Thanks, guys.